Veteran banker Jose Querubin formally takes oath as the newest member of the Philippine Central Bank's Monetary Board, the highest policy-making body of the Banco Central. Querubin took his oath at the BSP's head office in Manila on Thursday. Before his new role, Querubin was the president of the United Coconut Planters Bank and a board member of ASEAN Finance Corporation. He replaces Anita Lindak Aquino, who resigned after she was linked to the ghost employee scandal that tarnished the reputation of the country's central bank. President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. vows to continue government programs that will alleviate the burden of Filipinos on food costs. This follows the easing of inflation to a seventh-month low in August. Lady Vicente reports.
Headline inflation eased to 3.3% in August after the 4.4% uptick in July, which breached the upper end of the government's inflation target. The Philippine Statistics Authority attributed the slowdown to lower food inflation, particularly in rice, bread, and meat. Rice inflation significantly dipped to 14.7% from July's 20.9%. Decrease in prices of gasoline and diesel was also a main contributor to the downtrend.
May pagbaba tayo ng presyo dun sa food, medyo may pagtaas tayo ng presyo dito sa housing. Of course, maganda ngayon dahil nung buwan ng Agosto, bumagsak yung transport kasi halos weekly, kung napansin ninyo, weekly bumababa yung presyo ng gasolina and diesel.
Kasi yung rice, about 25% ng kabuang food inflation dahil sa bigas. So kung bababa palalo yung bigas, lalong bababa yung food inflation at malaki yung magiging epekto sa kabuang inflation numbers.
President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. attributed the easing of rice inflation to the government's rice tariff cut. Through Executive Order 62, rice tariff was lowered to 15% from 35% to address inflation. PSA data show rice prices went down by at least 20 centavos in August after the EO was implemented. But for agriculture group Samhang Industriya ng Agrikultura, the EO remains ineffective in sustaining lower prices for the staple. Sinag calls for the repeal of the EO.
Kung may review, actually, sasabihin natin baka pwede na siyang i-repeal dahil hindi naman niya na-achieve yung kanyang objective na pababain ng presyo. Nalulugay pa ang farmers dahil bumabagsak ang farm gate. Pangatlo, nawawalan pa ng revenues ang government.
The Banco Central ng Pilipinas projects inflation to settle within the 2-4% target range for the rest of the year until 2025, despite upside risks that could potentially derail projections.
Palagi nating tinitingnan yung mga risks naman. Dito, for example, nakita natin, hindi nyo lang na-highlight, no? Yung housing, water, electricity, gas, and other fuels. Tumaas siya. Ang ating expectation naman ay tataas ito hanggang October, particularly doon sa electricity. So, substantial din kasi yung weight ng housing, water, electricity, gas, and other fuels. And kasama rito yung LPG. Ito naman, ito yung nakikitaan natin ng pagtaas ng presyo.
For the National Economic and Development Authority, sustained easing of inflation is expected to boost household consumption and encourage investments with a decline of borrowing costs. Finance Secretary Ralph Recto, meanwhile, says the slower inflation in August shows the effectiveness of targeted interventions to stabilize food prices. He assured the public that government will not be complacent and will proactively monitor potential inflationary risks to address them in a timely manner. Lady Vicentio, ABS-CBN News.
The U.S.-ASEAN Business Council presents to the Philippine government a report outlining the training and upskilling initiatives undertaken by its member companies. These initiatives are designed to enhance the skills and employability of Filipinos. They target more than 100,000 members of the workforce and students covering AI cybersecurity, data analytics, and financial literacy. The U.S.-ASEAN Business Council in May this year committed to bear initiatives of member companies that respond to the government's call to reskill and upskill workers. Member companies include Amazon, Citigroup, as well as Coca-Cola, Google, and Visa. The chair of the Philippine Energy Regulatory Commission slapped with a six-month preventive suspension. The ombudsman suspended Mona Lisa de Malanta for allegedly violating a law regulating the sale of electricity. The ombudsman had acted on a complaint of the National Association of Electricity Consumers for Reforms, which alleged that de Malanta had illegally allowed the Meralco Power Distributor to bill consumers for more expensive energy bought from the wholesale electricity spot market. De Malanta says she is surprised by the decision.
Nagulat kayo, ako din po nagulat. Sa back of my mind naman, alam ko one of these days may darating po na ganito. Kasi sa trabaho naman natin, pag ginulo mo yung status ko, merong aalma. Nagulat ko lang, hindi kasi tayo nakatanggap ng complaint. Up to this day, wala pa rin po ako natatanggap na kopya ng complaint officially at wala din akong kopya ng order pa.
Motorists await another rollback in fuel prices next week. The Energy Department expects gasoline and diesel to fall by as much as 1 peso and 30 centavos per liter. Kerosene also expected to fall by at least a peso and 20 centavos per liter. Meanwhile, beginning October 1st, oil firms will increase the biodiesel blend to 3% from the current 2%. This will further increase in the next 2 years. The Biofuels Act of 2006 mandates that all liquid fuels for motors and engines contain locally sourced biofuel components in a bid to help reduce pump prices and support the local industry. Under the circular, oil companies can also offer gasoline fuel containing 20% bioethanol blend voluntarily from the current 10%. A dozen local onion traders charged for manipulating the onion market. The Competition Commission filed the cases as it accused 12 traders of behaving like a cartel. The antitrust body adds the traders entered into anti-competitive deals for the supply of imported onions. It also accused them of working together to control prices and limit competition, which is harmful to consumers and the economy. The Bureau of Plant Industry says the suspects will be banned from applying for import clearances. The price of red onions spiked to as high as 700 pesos per kilo in January last year, allegedly due to supply problems. A climate financing firm eyes stronger efforts in connecting climate resilience projects in the Philippines with public and private investors. Climate fund managers made this statement as government aims to build communities that could withstand the effects of climate change. Several parts of the country are still reeling from massive floods following days of rains brought by severe tropical storm Enteng and the southwest monsoon.
We manage funds from the governments, most of these governments from the EU, from the Netherlands, they have allocations basically for mitigating climate change, not only in their countries but around the globe, particularly in countries that need the financing, emerging markets, developing countries. We want to make water infrastructure outside of Metro Manila also resilient, provide access to clean water to communities. We're partnered with a local firm called Tubig Pilipinas. And then we're also supporting waste and bioenergy in the Philippines. We have projects out for this year. And then we're very heavy on corporate and industrial renewable energy.
The Philippine Transportation Department plans to deploy the Chinese-made Dalian trains on the MRT-3 by mid-2025. 48 of the trains purchased for 3.7 billion pesos during the Aquino administration have remained unused due to compatibility issues with the railway system. But the DOTR says the supplier has already made necessary adjustments.
Ang direction talaga is gamitin sana because this will mean that it will provide us additional capacity of 200,000 per day. Right now, our current fleet, no, which is our CKD trains, our capacity is at around 418,000, and we are now averaging a daily ridership of around 380. If we return the Dalian trains, it will take a minimum of 5 to 7 years bago dumating yung mga bagong trains na bibilhin natin. So it will mean na 5 to 7 years pang magtitiis ang ating mga mananakay.
Senator Raffy Tulfo, who previously called for an investigation on the trains, urges officials to refile graft charges against those involved in the procurement of the incompatible trains. The DOTR noted that it filed cases in 2017 against former Department of Transportation and Communications Secretary June Abaya and other people involved, but these were dismissed by the ombudsman. Time Magazine unveils its second annual list of the 100 most influential people in artificial intelligence. Topping the list for leadership, Google and Alphabet CEO Sundar Pichai. Time notes Google began channeling resources towards AI more than 2 decades ago, and its scientists are responsible for many of the breakthroughs that drove the field to its current inflection point. Pichai is among the 40 CEOs, co-founders and co-founders on the list that also include Mark Zuckerberg of Meta, Satya Nadella of Microsoft, and Sam Altman of OpenAI. It also includes dozens of leading women in the field, including AMD CEO Lisa Su, U.S. Secretary of Commerce Gina Raimondo, and Sarah Hooker, lead for AI at enterprise platform Cohere. Time says while last year's lineup was dominated by the emergence of startups, this year's list offers examples of the possibilities for AI when it moves out of the lab and into the real world.